Hello everyone, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. StudySalesforce.com, this is my website. You can visit it to learn Salesforce. So in this video, I'm going to demonstrate you the scenario which is particularly related to Apex. So after understanding basic features of Apex, you might need some use cases. Those are demonstrated with the help of various features, those are available in the Apex. So for that purpose, I am creating this video. So scenario says like, we need to query account records, those are created this year. So there may be different scenarios like this year or maybe last year, this week, last week, next week. So whatever scenario you have, accordingly, you need to apply SOQL first, then we need to insert one opportunity record for each account. So based on the query, whatever our account records we are querying, so we need to associate or we need to create one opportunity record under that account record. So this is our requirement. So I hope you understood this thing. Now I am moving to Salesforce org and developer console so that I can show you how we can write the code for this. So first of all, let's implement SOQL so that we can use that SOQL in our method so that all the account records will be available. Those are created in this week. So for that, you can write select ID name from account where created date equals to this year. So basically select from where these are the keywords. So best practice says like you can use these in capital, but Apex is case sensitive. So if you write in small, so that also works. So if I click on execute, so here you can see in this year, total 13 records are created. So their IDs and names are listed over here. So it means our query is working fine. So we can copy this query and use it here in particular method. So now I'm going to create a method. So this will be the name of method, create opportunity on account, then I'm creating list of account, ACC list equals to, and then in square brackets, you can paste your SOQL, right? So right now I have used SOQL here and the result will be available into account list. So I hope you know whenever we apply SOQL, so result will be always in form of list. So you need to create a list so that you can store the result. But if you are using this SOQL result into a list, like if you are using ACC list in a loop for iteration. So in that scenario, you can directly use SOQL in the loop as well. So right now I'm going to use this ACC list in the loop. Then after execution, I will show you like how you can replace it with SOQL directly inside the loop. Then I will be requiring one opportunity list. So this is the name. Right. Now, after creating these two variables, so ACC list is having some records of account object. Opportunity to be created, this instance is blank. So before applying loop, I just need to check ACC list. So here we can use two things, like either we can check the size and then we can apply the loop, or you can use isEmpty method and accordingly you can use it. Right. If you want to use isEmpty method, so I'm just giving you brief demo. So you need to remove this. So this way you can apply isEmpty. So if ACC list is empty, then this condition will be true. But if it is not empty, then we want to go inside the if condition. So you need to apply not here. So it depends on your choice, like which if you want to use, both are correct. So I'm just erasing this using this one. Now here I'm going to apply for each So it will iterate on this account list. So one by one, each account record will be available into this ACC. And inside this for loop, you can create opportunities and you can add those opportunities into list. So I hope you remember, if you saw my earlier videos, those I created based on some features, those are available in Apex. So there I told you, like, as part of best practice, don't use SOQL and DML inside the loop. So if you are implementing a loop, so you can create a list, and after completion of loop, you can use that list to insert, delete, update records. So by watching this example, you will get to know like how we can do that. So now I'm creating one instance of opportunity. Now I need to fill the required fields of opportunity. So here I'm putting name. So opportunity name will be similar to account name. Then next is close date. So here I'm putting system.today and opportunity.stage name equals to prospecting. So these are three required fields which are required on opportunity. So whenever you try and create any opportunity record, and if you don't fill anything, so here you can see these three, close date, opportunity name, and stage are required. So if you are creating any record through code, then also you need to take care of those. Now the requirement is we need to link all these opportunities with particular account. So here you can see ACC list is iterating. So one by one account will be available in this ACC instance. So now what you can do, you can use this account ID lookup field that is available on opportunity. And this you can fill with this ACC.ID. So whatever account record will be available in this ACC, that record's ID will be assigned into this account ID. So that newly created opportunity will be linked with that account. Now you can copy this and you can add opportunity into this list. So this is part of best practice, like you can't use DML inside loop because of governor limits. So you can add opportunities into a list. Then after completion of this loop and if block, you can check size of this list. If it is greater than zero, so you can write insert opportunities to be created. So this list will be inserted and opportunity records will be created. So this way our code is complete. Now we are all set to execute this. So to test this code, basically what we can do, we right now we have not implemented any trigger, so this code won't be executing automatically, right? So what we need to do, we need to click on debug and open execute an inverse window, and here you can call this method. So name of class is my demo and this is the method, create opportunities on account. So I need to modify this, right? So now if I click on execute, so this method, okay, so there's a mistake, line one, column 26. Okay, so we need to check it. So here, curly, this is our closed, this is also closed, this is closed, why it is showing. So actually, I just forgot to put semicolon after this statement. So now if I try to execute this, it will work fine. So code executed, now it's time to move to opportunities first. So you will see lots of opportunities created. So here you can see all these opportunities are created today, all 13, having same account name. So opportunity name and account name are same. This is today's date. right? So you can check it here, 27 October. So here you can see the dates. Stage is prospecting and close date is today's date, right? So everything is fine. And if you move to account, so here also, if you open any account record, so you will see related opportunity with that name. So here you can see United Oil and Gas Corporation. So this is the name of opportunity and account name is also same. So this way, if you implement this code, so you will be able to create one opportunity under each account. Now I'm going to show you how you can remove this. So you can copy this. Now here we can paste it this way. So you don't need this if condition anymore. So maybe we can comment this as well, and we can comment this as well, right? So what is happening here? We applied SOQL directly here, right? And the result which will be returning from this SOQL will be available automatically in a list, and one by one, those account records will be available in this ACC, and rest of the things will remain same. Now, if this query, let's say you are trying to fetch some records, but there is no record available in the org. So null check will be automatically applied here. And if this is the case, this for each loop won't be executed. And here also we applied this check. So if it is null and don't have any record, so this insert operation won't be executed. So that's why we need to apply these null checks always, so that unnecessary statements we can avoid, like at the time of execution. So this is all about the scenario that I demonstrated you. So we queried account records, those are created this year. Then we inserted one opportunity record for each account. So studysalesforce.com, a video library to learn Salesforce, you can visit and find lots of video links there. Thank you for watching this video.